Miracle worker. You are the miracle worker. Oh, come and do a miracle today, Jesus. You will do a miracle today. Your name is Yahweh, your name is Yahweh. You are the miracle working God, your name is Yahweh. Father, the miracle working God, we bless your holy name. We thank you because you are good, you are kind, you are the Almighty, you rule in the affairs of men. Please accept our worship in Jesus' name. Lord, that which you have ordained, that which you have proposed for this day, perfect in Jesus' name. And let your name be glorified. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Give us understanding, heal the sick, set the captives free, destroy the yoke of darkness in our lives. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. God bless you this day, Thursday, August 26, 2021. Our devotional written by Father-in-law, Pastor Iyadeboye, has a topic that says, qualified for a miracle. Qualified for a miracle. And we'll be looking at the Word of God together from the book of Matthew, chapter 15, verse 28, where we have our memory verse, Matthew chapter 15, verse 28. It says, then Jesus answered and said to her, O woman, great is thy faith. Be it unto thee even as thou wilt. And her daughter was made whole from that very hour. And her daughter was made whole from that very hour. I want us to read the Bible passage also from Matthew chapter 15, from verse 22. Matthew chapter 15, from verse 22, we'll stop in verse 28. And behold, a woman of Canaan came out of the same coast and cried unto him, saying, have mercy on me, O Lord, thou son of David. My daughter is grievously vexed with a devil. But he answered her not a word. And his disciple came and besought him, saying, send her away, for she cried after us. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Then came she and worshipped him, saying, Lord, help me. But he answered and said, it is not meet to take the children's bread and to cast it to dogs. And she said, truth, Lord, yet the dogs eat of the crumbs which fall from their master's table. Then Jesus answered and said unto her, O woman, great is thy faith. Be it unto thee even as thou wilt. And her daughter was made whole from that very hour. Wow. Wow. Qualified for a miracle, the woman pulled through and got the miracle she desired. May the Almighty God grant your desire this morning and give you miracles in the name of Jesus Christ. Our friend-in-law says the simple explanation for a miracle is that it is a supernatural event that does not follow the laws of natural cause, the law of nature. To favor a person, to be a blessing to a person, to turn things around for a person, to be a candidate for a miracle, the first qualification that such a fellow must have is to be a carrier of the living God. Be a carrier of the living God. He or she must be a child of God because God created man in his own image. The Bible says in Genesis chapter 1, verse 27, so God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him, male and female created him. God created us. Bible says in Isaiah chapter 43, he created us for his glory. He created us for testimonies. He created us for miracles, signs, and wonders. He created us to show forth his praise. And when miracle happens, when divine intervention happens, we automatically return all the glory and praise unto his name. So when the carrier of God's image, man, got entangled with sin, he needed to be restored. And the only one who could do this was God himself. The only one who could do this was God himself. God achieved the restoration through his only begotten son, Jesus Christ. For us to be partakers of this miracle of redemption, we must believe him to access his power. We must believe him to access his power. In John chapter 1, 11 to 12, John chapter 1, he said, he came to his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. Even to them that believe on his name. Beloved, you simply cannot partake of the miraculous without belonging to the miracle working God. You remember that scripture that we read now? He said, you do not give your bread, children's bread, to the dogs. So you have to be a child of God. You must belong to God. You must acknowledge God. You must believe in him. He said, believe in the Lord your God, you shall be established. Believe in his prophet, and you will prosper. There's this relationship that must have been there before you expect miracle to happen in your life. It's a supernatural event that suspends every natural law. The Lord will encounter you afresh today in Jesus' name. So do you desire a miracle? That's a very wonderful question. You must be born again. You must belong to God, the miracle working God. Why? Jesus Christ said it's clearly that miracles are children's bread. You can't have them until you become a child of God. You cannot have them until you become a child of God. That is what that Matthew chapter 15, 22 to 28 is telling us. You cannot have miracles except you become a child of God. We are not talking about magic. We are not talking about coincidence. We are talking about divine intervention, supernatural visitation. For every good and every perfect gift come from above, the Father of light, with whom there is no variableness, no shadow of turning. So you need to have this understanding that God is a miracle worker. You need to belong to him. So my prayer is that you will give your life over to the miracle worker if you have not done that already, so that you too can begin to experience miracles in your life, so that you begin to experience the mighty hand of God in your life. If you are already a child of God, then you are already qualified for a miracle as long that you are living by his word. Abide in me, and I abide in you. That's what Jesus says. Then your Father in heaven will be glorified. Abide in Christ, abide in the word of God, and your life will never remain the same. Another thing that can qualify you for a miracle is faith. Faith. Jesus commended the faith of that woman, and she got what she needed. Jesus said, your faith has made you whole. Get what you have believed. Get what you have desired because of your faith. We need faith. Bible says it is impossible to please God without faith. So we need faith to receive from the Lord. So I encourage you to come to God in faith today, and those intimidating situations in your life shall become history in the name of Jesus. Those tormenting issues, just go to him. He will not cast you away. He said, come unto me, all ye that labor, that are heavy laden. I will give you rest. Come. Believe in him. Come. In Romans chapter 10, 12 to 14, he said, how will they believe if they don't preach? How will they hear if there's no preacher that will tell them? And you must believe because you have heard the word of God, and the word of God will be fulfilled in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. So, as the doctor said, the baby in that womb is dead and must be evacuated. I speak to that baby now to receive the life of God in Jesus' name. That part of your body that is suffering from paralysis must receive the life of God now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I stand by the word of God in Romans chapter 8, 11 that declare that if that same spirit that raised Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he that raised Jesus from the dead shall also quicken your mortal body by the Spirit who dwells in you. Because the Holy Spirit dwells in you as a child of God, you need to believe and be quickened in your mortal body, irrespective of the medical reports, irrespective of what you are witnessing and feeling in your body now. The miracle worker will visit you in the name of Jesus. Receive miracle from him now in the name of Jesus Christ, because it's a supernatural event from God through his mighty hand, and it will fulfill you in the name of Jesus Christ. So don't suffer in silence. Cry to God in your distress, in your confusion. Cry to God, and he will attend to you in the name of Jesus Christ. What is the prayer point today? The prayer point says, Father, I believe you are the miracle working God. Please give me a miracle today in the mighty name of Jesus. I believe you are the miracle working God. Give me a miracle. I believe. Give me a miracle that will make me to glorify your holy name in the name of Jesus Christ. Very, very important. And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. You see, our memory verse again, in Matthew chapter 15, verse 28, it has a lot to tell us today. It said, then Jesus answered and said unto her, O woman, great is thy faith. Be it unto thee even as thou wilt. And her daughter was made whole from that very hour. Her daughter was made whole from that very hour. So you need to go to Jesus. You need to trust him. You need to believe in the victory of the cross. You need to believe in the resurrection power of Jesus. And your life will never remain the same in Jesus' name. Our hymn today is hymn 7. Hymn 7. Have you been to Jesus? Have you been to Jesus? So I want to encourage you this morning, especially if you are not born again, give your life to Jesus Christ. Let Jesus come into your heart. And you begin to experience one miracle after the other, and your life will never remain the same. Jesus is Lord. God bless you. Shall we please pray? Father, we give you praise. Thank you for who you are. Thank you for your grace upon our lives. Please accept our worship in Jesus' name. Lord, that which you have set to do in our lives, even by reason of this entrance of your word, perfect in Jesus' name. Is there anyone that is sick in their body? Holy Spirit, begin to quicken sickness, affliction, infirmity out of their lives in the name of Jesus Christ. By the time we see again, it shall be full of testimonies. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. See you soon. May the Lord keep you and deliver unto you miracle, signs, and wonder. God bless you. Amen.
Salt, blessed blood of the Lord. Are you then why does no? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Oh, Joshua, Wadamu, itutaka sayo ya kondo. Ziwe safi, nguo nyeupe sana.